Bringing life science research to the market is a journey that requires not only scientific talent, but also business acumen and funding. BioInnovation Institute's Venture Lab program supports early-stage founders from all over the world in turning cutting-edge, transformative ideas into validated concepts. The 12-month program helps accelerate your startup by testing, validating, and executing key experiments to get you ready for a seed investment. With a risk-free convertible loan of 500,000 euros and incubation at the BII office and lab space in Copenhagen, you will work with three main pillars to develop your startup: science, business, and team. During the whole program, you will have the support of an experienced anchor from the BII business development team and access to our global network of experts and investors. So if you have a science-based idea within therapeutics, bioindustrials, or health tech, accelerate your startup to reach seed funding with BII Venture Lab program. Read more and apply on BII.dk.
Hello, my name is Bobby Soni, and I'd like to give an introduction of the BioInnovation Institute in Copenhagen, Denmark. I'd like to thank the organizers of the NextRise conference for allowing me the opportunity to present. So in this presentation today, I'll talk more about what is the BII, what we do, and talk more about our portfolio. What I'd be interested in hearing from the conference are parties that are interested in expanding their geographical reach from outside of Korea to Europe and potentially working with the BII and are potentially investing in our portfolio. And we'd be open to that discussion, and we look forward to hearing from you. I'll start with what is the BII? BioInnovation Institute, we are what is called a Danish Enterprise Foundation. So that is essentially a non-profit foundation. And we were funded by a grant of up to 470 million euros by the Novo Nordisk Foundation. So the Novo Nordisk Foundation is the ultimate owner of the pharmaceutical company Novo Nordisk and Novozymes, and also has the investment arm Novo Holdings. So the funds they are a non-profit foundation as well. And they essentially fund science through a series of institutes in the city of Copenhagen, and we are their nearest institute in Copenhagen dedicated to innovation and entrepreneurship. And the way we work is we act as a bridge between academia, science at universities, and their ability to create companies that attract investments from investors and industry and are real businesses. So essentially the hypothesis is that there's a lot of very good science out there that isn't being translated into products, and the BII is here to help bridge that gap. We're located here in the city of Copenhagen, and this area is well known for a high research quality. Our building is next to the University of Copenhagen, it's next to the regional hospital, University Hospital here in Copenhagen, and we're surrounded by excellent research organizations here in Denmark and in Sweden. And what we're trying to do is work with this science initially, but our plan is also to work internationally and attract science from all over the world. We work in three areas. We work in therapeutics, bioindustrials, and health tech. Most of our deal flow is in the area of therapeutics. Most of our portfolio is in the area of therapeutics, but bioindustrials and health tech are also very important to us, and we're starting to see a growing portfolio in both. The way we work is we select startups and we provide what we believe are the four key elements that are missing for their success. First is, of course, funding. Many investors will not fund early stage research. Translational research, we will do that. We provide knowledge, so every company at the BII is provided an anchor from our BD team that helps them navigate the fundraising process. We have our network, where we have a large network of VC investors and industrial partners that work with our startups and provide feedback, and eventually also invest in those startups. And we also have infrastructure. So we have, we're located in central Copenhagen. We have wet lab facilities and office space. And importantly, the wet lab facilities are fully equipped with both equipment and disposables. So a small company of 3-4 people, for example, can just start doing the killer experiments that they need to do to prove that their technology has value. So we started in 2018, and things are accelerating quickly. So this slide is almost out of date, but we have 480 projects reviewed, brought in 78 teams. We have funded with 45 million euros of our funding, but companies have since then raised 27 million euros of investment financing from others, especially if three companies have recently received Series A funding in the last 12 months. We have a growing brand awareness in our region, including over 8,000 now followers on LinkedIn and high readership of our newsletter. So the goal is to continue the cadence of our funding such that over the next 10 years, we will have deployed $400 million into early stage startups with the goal for them to obtain further financing. So I'll talk more about our programs and how we work with them. So we have three programs at the BII. So we source projects from hospitals, universities, industry, entrepreneurs, and we have the Venture Lab program, the Creation House program, and the Faculty program. All three of these programs are funded by the BII, we provide support to those programs via the BD team and via subsidized access to our infrastructure and our partners. We also have a residence program for more mature companies that rent space at the BII, and we believe that helps provide a mature element to our community, and that these residents can help our startups as well. So the three pillars of Venture Lab, and the three pillars of all of our programs, are science, business, and team. So in the Venture Lab program, we run this twice a year. There are five startups per cohort. It's a 12-month program. They receive 4 million kroner, which is approximately 800,000 euros, in the form of a convertible loan. And the focus is on figuring out what is the product that is of need here, what is the unmet need that they need to fill, and what is the product they need to create, what is the killer experiment that shows that their technology can create that product, and start to think about their team. Who are the new members of the team that they need to be successful? Creation House has also these three pillars, but the companies are more advanced. So here we have 10 startups per cohort. It's an 18-month program. We provide them 1.3 million euros in the form of convertible loan. And the focus is really on getting these companies ready for fundraising. So we work on the team side. We work very much on hiring external chairs that can help them fundraise. On the business plan, we help them. We help make sure that their TPP, target product profile, is in place, and that they're pitching to our VCs with a mature, understandable, attractive pitch. On the science side, they continue product development towards a clinic or towards a market as needed. Faculty program is slightly different, still focused on science, business, and team, but these are grants. So we invite PIs to join us at the BII, and we can run a translational research project from this PI at the BII. The idea is, by running this project at the BII, they're surrounded by everything else that we do, that it'll have a great chance of becoming a real company at the end of the granting period and be spun out of the university. So this is a grant for 18 million kroner, approximately 2.5 million euros. And we take high technical risk here with the idea of creating things that otherwise could not be created. And the way we run find companies is we run an open call process. We receive applications. The business development team does due diligence. We initially shortlist, share the shortlist applicants with our partners. So this can be local IP companies. This could be Back Bay, life science advisors in Boston that help us on commercial analysis, Lux that helps us commercial analysis on bioindustrials. We take all that diligence, and then our applicants pitch to our advisory group. And our advisory group consists of tier one venture funds with knowledge and experience in what companies could be fundable post-BII. And this is an important part of our selection process. For us, it's very important that companies that enter the BII are fundable at the BII and can succeed post-BII. So the advisory group provides us advice. The final decision on what is taken into the BII is at our board approval. Once at the BII, companies have access to our partners. So the BII has negotiated good deals, but more importantly, high quality and good contact with partners in different areas. So we work with Kulta Partners, for example, a renowned search firm, to help our companies find their team members and their chair. Wuxi to help them with their to run their experiments, and also technical support. And we work with Back Bay for commercial. We have communications help, IP help, soft funding help, and accounting and bookkeeping as well. So everything a company needs to be successful, we intend to have a partner that can help them on their way. Talk a little bit about our portfolio here. And in our last call, just to show that this is the deal flow that we received in our most recent call, showing that we have excellent coverage of most Scandinavian universities. And from that deal flow, we're able to pick companies. And this is the current state of our portfolio. You can see in Creation House, it's primarily therapeutics, and it ranges from early stage hits and platforms to companies that are entering GLP tox studies. Those companies that are shaded in blue have already raised money. So a company like Adicendo recently raised 50 million euros, a company like Stipe raised 20 million euros, and Cinclino raised 2 million euros. So we're quite proud of those achievements to take them in as university spin-outs and take them straight to such large investment rounds. And the same in bioindustrials. Our portfolio here is growing. It covers everything from biomaterials, plastics made from fermentation, to carbon capture, animal health. We're seeing a lot of work in the food and ag industry. But also platform technologies to aid in fermentation or synthetic biology in the production of cannabinoids, for example, in the case of Ocotrin. Maybe our most advanced product here is Sundew, which may be quite relevant for this audience, working on a compound to prevent diseases in fish aquaculture, which is non-toxic and biodegradable. And our faculty projects are shown here. It ranges from, of course, therapeutics, health tech, and bioindustrials, primarily Danish PIs at the moment, but our intention is to expand this to have international PIs join our faculty program here at the BII. So with that, I will thank everyone here for their attention. Should you be interested in hearing more about the BII, you're welcome to contact us at our email, info@BII.dk. We'd be especially interested in hearing from parties that are interested in expanding their geographic reach into Europe, and we'd very much like to be a partner for that. Alternatively, companies that are interested in investing in our early stage portfolio, we'd like to hear from you as well. I'll say thank you very much, and thanks again to the organizers for inviting me to present.